Indiana Jones would really hate our next story. Check out that monster snake. The prehistoric Titan boa was as long as a school bus. It could eat crocodiles whole. Once ruled parts of South America. But nobody has ever seen it like this until now. Thanks in part to a researcher at the University of Nebraska. KATV News Watch 7's Andrew Ozaki has this new story tonight.
Okay.
Zandam the boa at the Children's Zoo in Lincoln doesn't strike much fear in these kids.
You don't want to grab him?
But imagine a snake that could easily swallow a small child whole.
Oh my.
Whoa. That's unbelievable.
But believe it, and this is what scientists think it looked like.
A terrifying stealth killer, straight from our darkest nightmares.
Luckily, this monster snake has been extinct for 60 million years.
The skull on this animal is about this big.
University of Nebraska paleontologist Jason Head is one of the researchers that have helped bring this prehistoric beast back to life in a scale model of the creature and a television documentary produced by the Smithsonian Channel.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime discovery. Really, this is just amazing.
Head is one of the world's foremost experts in the evolution of reptiles. He was contacted via video call after scientists discovered the snake's fossil remains in a Colombian mine in 2002.
The minute it came on the screen, I knew that it was the largest snake in the world.
At 49 feet, 2,500 pounds, or nearly twice the size of the largest snakes today, they fittingly call it Titanoboa.
The important thing isn't just that it's a giant snake. I mean, that's amazing and cool. But what's really important is what this tells us about Earth's climate, Earth's environment over time.
Head believes it had to be very warm for the creature to grow so large. Global cooling may be what killed the animal.
There have been lots of questions asked about whether or not giant snakes could evolve again with man-made global warming, and the answer is probably not.
A comforting thought.
I would just run.
In Lincoln, Andrew Ozaki, KETV, News Watch 7.
Jason Head attended the opening of the Titanoboa exhibit at the Smithsonian earlier this month. It's coming to Lincoln, but not until 2014.